Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back again for this second lesson of this week. Okay, second lesson of this week. Hari Raya week, because it's a public holiday. We only have one lesson only during the Hari Raya week. Okay, next week, I think still as usual. Okay, as usual, we have two lessons next week. Hari Raya, I think it's on the 23rd, 24th, isn't it? When is it? Hanis, when is Hari Raya? Hanis?
Yes, sir, 24.
24 lah. 24 is what day lah? What day?
I don't know.
Don't know. 24th is maybe like this lah. If 24th is, I think I check here is Sunday. Okay, Sunday. No? Okay, so the following weeks are Monday, Tuesday, and no tuition. So the week after Hari Raya, we only have one lesson only. Okay? One day only. I think it's Thursday. Okay? Next week, still as usual, we have two lessons next week. Okay? Right. Okay, now. Today we start lesson three, you know. Okay, do you remember or not? In this chapter two, your first lesson is magnetic field, correct? Not is something you do with magnetic field, electromagnet, correct? Not your second lesson is focus on the magnetic force. We have Fleming's left hand rule, okay, in lesson two, right? Fleming's left hand rule. So where you study a force, a magnetic force is produced when current flows through a magnetic field. You remember not this hand, Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, this Fleming's left hand rule is chapter two, you know. Then today, you're going to study Fleming's right hand rule, your right hand pula. Or today, you have to use your right hand, you know, no more using left hand. So let's look at a paper now, your lesson three paper, okay? All right, the paper is here, your lesson three, okay? The title is Electromagnetic Induction. You see now, let me explain the meaning of induction to you. What is the meaning of induction? Okay, electromagnetic induction. Okay, so you remember, you know, induction means it's a process of producing electric current. So meaning that in this lesson you are going to learn the process of induction. Induction means so far until now in the history of mankind, right, we only have this method used to generate electricity. We use the electricity we use every day now is generated through this process, electromagnetic induction. Okay, the words electromagnet, I think you know already, right? Electromagnet means consisting, electric, magnet, correct? Not. Now this, in other words, induction. Okay, induction means to produce. Induction means produce. So we use electromagnet to produce current. So we call it induction. So the process of generating current is called electromagnetic induction. So it's very important you learn today. All right, let's see another set of paper. Now we look at your paper. You have this set of paper, right? Everyone, okay, come. Okay, what is the meaning of electromagnetic induction? So please highlight the meaning of electromagnetic induction is the production of induced current. Okay, induced current means the current generated. So we call it induced current. The production of induced currents or induced EMF, electromagnetic force, I told you before, right? Actually, electromagnetic force, the voltage and the current, they come together, they exist at the same time, they come together one. The production of induced current or induced EMF without using power supply, never use electric energy นะ by using relative motion between a conductor and a magnet. Okay, roughly you memorize the meaning of this. What is the meaning of electromagnetic induction, right? It's a process of producing induced current by using the concept of relative motion between a conductor and a magnet. Okay, come, you look at this diagram first. Here, look at this diagram, huh? On this diagram, right, you have a coil of wire here, solenoid. This is solenoid. Then this is a bar magnet. You already know surrounding the bar magnet, you have this magnetic field, right? Magnetic field from north to south, north to south. So this is magnetic field. But in this lesson, we don't call them magnetic field. We call them magnetic flux. Magnetic flux. Okay, what happened is like this, you know. The process of generating current is actually very simple one, you know. When you want to have current, you just push the magnet, push in, pull out, in, out. Then you can have current already. Okay, why? Because when I push the magnet in, right, all these magnetic flux are cut by this wire. Okay, cut by the wire. All this magnetic field, magnetic flux cut by the wire, right? Okay, you remember the concept. Once a magnetic flux are cut by the wire, that is called electromagnetic induction. It can produce current. So the moment you see that this magnet you push in, so all this magnetic flux cut by this wire one time, two time, three, four, five times, right? Immediately you notice that the pointer of this galvanometer deflected. You see the pointer move. It show that current generated. Okay. Then after that, when you pull the magnet out, you pull magnet out, also same. When you pull the magnet out, right, this same magnetic flux also cut by the wire. Then you can see the pointer deflect to another side. It shows that current generated but flow in the other direction. Okay? So meaning that, remember, the process of generating current, right, is using the concept of magnetic flux cut by conductor. That's it. Okay. When this magnetic flux cut by this conductor, this wire, right? You push this magnet in, you will cut, isn't it? Cut this magnetic flux. Then it can produce current. It's whether you push in or you pull out. Pull out also same magnetic flux you cut by the wire, right? Okay. So remember the keyword, please jot it down, you know. Magnetic flux cut by solenoid, cut by this wire. Okay. So what happened is change in magnetic flux happened. Okay, change in magnetic flux means is the magnetic flux being cut by the conductor. We use a right term. We say change in magnetic flux. Okay. Come look at here. What is meant by relative motion? You must wonder what is relative motion, right? Okay, relative motion is like this lah. So this solenoid not moving, but the magnet move. This one not moving, but this one move in, out, in, out. That is called relative motion. Relative motion means one thing static, the other one moving. So it's relative motion. Or both objects are moving, but move in opposite direction. That also consider relative motion. Relative motion, they are moving, moving in opposite direction, or one not moving, one moving, like this one. This coil not moving, but a magnet move in, out, that is considered relative motion, okay? Okay, when the relative motion between a conductor or a magnet happen, right, between conductor, the wire here, and the magnet happen, the conductor cut across the magnetic field lines, okay, highlight, the conductor, which is the wire, cut across the magnetic field line. So we call them magnetic flux or chains of magnetic flux happen. Understand? Okay. If question asks, what is the concept to produce current? So the concept is electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetic induction involving the cutting of magnetic flux by wire or conductor the cutting of magnetic flux นะโอเค when you look at this diagram นะ how you want to produce speaker current so very simple right you want to produce speaker current so you push the magnet in out faster นะ you push the magnet in out faster okay because the faster you push and pull out right means the rate of change of magnetic flux means the magnetic flux being cut more magnetic flux cut faster so you have bigger induced current bigger current okay another method is you use a stronger magnet this magnet you use a very very strong magnet very powerful magnet of course lah powerful magnet when you push in I can produce a lot of current understand okay huh? All right next another method this method I see the magnet is here okay you see another two pieces of magnet one piece here another piece is here so in between here you have magnetic flux so now the magnetic flux is here you know in this case the relative motion happens is like this you know the magnet not moving but you move the wire up down to cut the magnetic flux okay you see now you are moving this wire up down to cut the magnetic flux lah. So it's the same lah. Also relative motion. Okay. Once the magnetic flux cut by this wire, you can produce current. You can see the pointer deflect here. Okay. So change in magnetic flux happen when the wire is moving up and down. Okay. You move the wire up, move the wire down to cut the magnetic flux so you can produce current. So you see actually, when you want to generate current, it's quite simple, isn't it? Right? Very simple. But the problem is, we need to produce the current consistently, continuously, 24 hours per day. That is a bit difficult, huh? You see, in the case like this, who can move the wire up and down to produce current non-stop 24 hours? Very hard, isn't it? Same thing goes to this one. Who can push the magnet in out to produce current 24 hours non-stop, right? So we have to think of another method to do it now, okay? Okay, can you jot down here, jot down this one? All right, the third method, okay, another one is here, okay? Third one is here, This one is a bit different, okay? Here now, there's no magnet, you know, you don't see any magnet here. No magnet can how to produce current. Okay? Right, you see here, got two solenoids. One is here, another solenoid is here, right? So this is just a resistor, nothing, real start. Okay, then here you have power supply, you have a tri-cell battery. Okay, what happened the case is like this. When you allow current to flow, right? So it will make this coil become electromagnetic. Do you remember or not? When current flow through a solenoid, this one will become electromagnetic. So this electromagnet will behave like bar magnet. So it will have magnetic flux, north to south, many magnetic flux, isn't it? Then you can see this magnetic flux will cut over here, you know, you see cut over here. Again, this magnetic flux, can cut over here. Okay, so cutting of magnetic flux happen here because this magnetic flux come here, cut it. Okay, then you can see current generated here by you on the switch, make this one to become magnet, then you have magnetic flux. This magnetic flux will link over or we say cut over to the coil Q. So that electromagnetic induction happen here, cutting of magnetic flux happen here, okay, to generate current. Okay, but the problem is like this, you know. When you on this switch, this is direct current. The current flow in same direction. Same direction means that this magnetic flux also constant magnetic flux, you know. Meaning that this magnetic flux will be stay here, cut one time only, it never come back. You only can cut one time. So current produce just a while only, then stop. You know why stop? Because if the magnetic flux are cut here one time only, never go back, right? So you can produce current just for a short moment. Okay, So to make the magnetic flux come over here to cut, it go back again, come again, go back again, come again, go back again, right? What you need to do is you on, off the switch alternately, understand? Because when you on the switch, magnetic flux come over here to cut. When you off the switch, the magnetic flux no more, so it come back. When it come back, also you cut here, you know, cut at that time because it go back. Then you on again, it come again. You off the switch, you go back. So by doing this, you on, off the switch here, you can make this magnetic flux cut here, go back, cut here, go back continuously. By doing that, you can produce current, right? Okay, put down here. Magnetic flux link over to the coil. Link over means a cut over here. Link over to coil Q when the switch X is on and off alternately. You must on and off alternately, you know. Because when you on, here magnet, so the flux cut here. When you off the switch, no more magnet already, so it will go back. When it go back, also consider cut second time. Then when you on again, it cut again, okay? By doing that, on and off the switch alternately, for this case to produce current. Then can you understand? Okay, the next one, how to produce current here? The magnet is here, magnetic field is here, north, south. So the wire is here, now this is a wire. Okay, how to make this wire cut this magnetic flux? To generate current, you must make this wire, the copper wire, cut the magnetic flux here. So simple, just swing it. Use a pendulum to carry this wire, swing to the left, right. When it go left, go right, you carry the wire, go here, cut, go back also cut, come again. So keep on cutting. Understand? So copper wire cut the magnetic flux when the bulb oscillates. When this one is oscillating, it will carry the wire to cut the magnetic flux, cut to the left, then cut to the right, to the left, to the right, it will continue to cut, correct not? So by when this thing is continuing to swing, so you can produce current. So you can see the galvanometer deflected. Understand? So now roughly you all know what is electromagnetic induction already, right? Okay. Then or not? Okay, come let me ask you a little bit question. Okay. Can Ming? Who can Ming? Are you there? Who can Ming? Can Ming? Can Ming not there? Okay. No I? Are you there? No I?
Yes, sir.
No I, Can you use a simpler way? Can you explain to me how to generate current? How to generate current? Use your own understanding. Can you tell me how to generate electricity? When it's at it, how to generate current when it's at it? Jay, can you tell me how to generate current now? I might find someone who can answer my question. Jay, how to generate current?
Cut the magnetic flux.
Using what? Using what to cut the magnetic flux?
Using magnet.
Using magnet cut magnet cut magnetic flux
Using the wire.
Using wire, using conductor to cut the magnetic flux. Okay, very simple, understand? There are so many methods you can use wire to cut the magnetic flux to produce current, right? That's simple. Rian Yu, are you there? Rian? Vienna, no sound already. Hui Xin, are you there? Quisena. Yes, sir. Quisena, can you tell me now what is the name of the process of producing current? What is the name of the process? What is the name of the process? What is the name of the process of generating current? The name, two words, son. What is the name? Huh? Liao Xing Xiang. Liao Xing Xiang. What is the name of the process of producing current? What is the name? Liao Xing Xiang.
Electromagnetic induction.
Yes, very good. Electromagnetic induction. So remember the terms, you know. Your title of your lesson 3, electromagnetic induction is a process of generating current. Nah. Because we use a wire to cut the magnetic flux. That's it. That is a process of electromagnetic induction to generate current. Right? Understand? Nah? Angel Tam, do you understand? Angel?
Yeah.
Angel, do you understand or not?
Yes.
Can you tell me what you understand, Angel Tam? Tell me what
use wire cut the magnetic flux.
Yes, use wire cut the magnetic flux to produce current, correct not?
Yeah.
Okay. Brandon? 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 Are you there? Brandon?
Uh-huh.
Brandon, can you tell me what is relative motion? Relative motion is what? What is relative motion?
Magnetic flux cut by solenoid.
Yaka. That one is change in magnetic flux, or we say electromagnetic induction. Ma. No, I'm asking you what is the meaning of relative motion. Relative motion is what? Jiu-tong. Jiu-tong, what is relative motion? What is that?
The magnet moving in and out of the solenoid.
Yes, correct. The magnet moving in and out, whereas the wire is not moving, correct not? One thing moving, the other one not moving, right? So that is called relative motion. Nah. Okay? Okay, So roughly you know what is that already, Kachuan, Li Kachuan, do you understand? Li Kachuan, long time never see you already. I miss you so much, Li Kachuan. Are you there? Li Kachuan? Li Kachuan, no sound. Yvonne, okay, Yvonne Teo. Yvonne, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You must listen, you know. Listen, I know. I only worried some of because some parents may complain, you know, complain say the son or daughter not paying attention Let the computer on, and then you're going to sit down there, play handphone. No lah, don't do like that lah, pay attention lah, Or Li Ka Chuan, okay, say yes, yes, understand. Okay, thank you, Li Ka Chuan. Yeah. Okay, come, let's move on Okay, the next one is types of induced current, okay? Types of induced current. Okay, before this, I want to ask you, what is induced current? What is induced current? How to explain induced current? Okay, very simple. Induced current means is a current generated by the process of electromagnetic induction. That's it. Okay? The current generated by electromagnetic induction, so we call it induced current. Okay, induced current got two, right? One is direct current DC, right? DC. Another one is AC. Later, you see DC first. Okay, how to produce DC? Using a solenoid, wire, this one using a magnet, right? So magnet, you must remember, surrounding the magnet, you have a lot of this magnetic flux, right? North to south, north to south, north to south magnetic flux. Okay, you want to produce direct current, current flow in one direction only. So what you must do is, you only push the magnet in one direction only. You push in, push one direction means it will produce a current in one direction. Okay, so it's called direct current. Okay, see here, highlight. Direct current is produced when the magnet move into, you either move into or out of the solenoid, one way only. You either move the magnet in one direction only, or you pull the magnet out one direction. Okay, remember, please jot out one direction only. When you move this magnet in only or out only, one direction only, then you can produce a direction, the current flow in one direction. So this is called direct current, DC. You see the graph, direct current. So why this direct current made? Because all positive. Here is positive, 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 positive. All flow in the same direction, all positive direction. So we call this as direct current. Okay? Direct current. So remember, you want to produce current, you push this thing move in one direction. Either go in only, or either go out only, one direction only. So that will be called direct current. You can generate direct current. Okay? All right, next. Another types of current is AC, alternating current. Okay, here. AC now. Then how to produce AC then? AC means the current keep changing direction one. No? Keep changing direction means like this. This one easier. You can push the magnet in, out, in, out. In one direction, out another direction. So by doing this, you can see the pointer. The pointer deflect to the right and also deflect to the left. So meaning that the direction the current produces AC current, alternating current. Okay, alternating current. The current flow in different direction of two direction. You see the graph got positive, negative, positive, negative. But this is AC current. So to produce AC current. So what you need to do is the magnets move into and when continue into and out of the solenoid. You push in, pull out, push in, pull out. So it's AC, okay? Alternating current, okay? Understand? Okay, now I want to ask you, between DC and AC, which type of current is easier to generate, easier to produce? Eric, which current easy to produce? AC or DC?
AC.
AC lah. Because AC very easy. It's just in, out, you know, simple like that only, right? Simple lah. Then DC a bit difficult, direct current, because you need to move in one direction only. That's a bit difficult, right? You cannot come out. So AC, simple, you can in, out, okay, like that, right? Okay, so now you know the difference between DC and AC already, And now, let's see, next is what? Okay, next one is determine the magnitude of induced current. Okay, Faraday's law, now. Tonight, you need to learn two important law. One is Faraday law. The other one is Lenz law. Okay? We go one by one. This one is, SPM. Sure, come out one. Okay? Faraday law. Faraday law. You must learn it all. Then what is Faraday law? Faraday's law state that the magnitude of induced current or induced EMF is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux linkage with the solenoid or the rate at which a conductor cut through the magnetic flux. It's meaning that, you say the magnitude of direct current, magnitude of induced current, mean the magnitude of current produced, right, is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux. Rate of change of magnetic flux means how fast the magnetic flux been cut, how fast you cut the magnetic flux. That is called rate of change of magnetic flux, right? Or rate at which a conductor cut through the magnetic flux. Okay, so what means by Faraday law is this, you know, he said, the faster you cut the magnetic flux, he said, the higher the rate of change of magnetic flux, the higher the magnitude of induced current, because he said directly proportional. This is common sense, right? That means now you use a wire, cut the magnetic flux faster. The higher the rate of change of magnetic flux, you cut it faster, then you can produce a bigger current. So he said, the higher the rate of change of magnetic flux, right, the bigger the magnitude of induced current. That is meant by Faraday's law. Faraday's law, I think, is not a problem to understand one, very easy to understand. But you need to remember the name, you know. Faraday's law, okay? Faraday's. Faraday's is the name of scientist, you know. Okay, Faraday's law. So we use his name to remember him, okay? Faraday. Okay, based on Faraday's law, so we say what, you know, there are three. So A, B, C, please highlight. Okay, the first one is, you say, the number of turns of solenoid is increased. Number of turns of solenoid mean here, you know, here. Okay. Look at here. When you have more wire here, more turns, right? When you have more turns here, indirectly means you can have more cutting of magnetic flux. In one push, you push the magnet in one time, you need, when you have more coil here, more wire, right? So you can cut more magnetic flux. So meaning that you can increase the current, no? Okay? So based on Faraday's law, he say, you know, you must have increased the number of turns here, okay? More turns like this, when you push this magnet in, you only cut one time, two times, three, four, five times only. But when you have more than 20 coils here, when you have 20 turns, you push the magnet in one time, you cut 20 times already. So the current becomes very, very high because rate of change of magnetic flux is higher. Okay, so highlight the first one. The number of turns of solenoid increase, first one. The second one, the strength of magnet increase, of course, like you make the magnet stronger, use a stronger magnet, use a more powerful magnet. Why use a more powerful magnet can increase the induced current? Because, you know why? Because it's like this. Stronger magnet will have more magnetic flux. Like this small magnet, the magnetic flux maybe not so much. But when you use a stronger magnet, more powerful magnet, you have more magnetic flux. More magnetic flux here. So when you push in, right, more magnetic flux will be cut more. So you can increase the current. Correct not? Okay, the second one. Okay, third one, see, the speed of the relative motion is increased. You move faster. In now faster. You see, when you move faster, so you cut faster, isn't it? When you cut faster means you can generate bigger current. Correct not? So please memorize. Okay, I give it to 1 minute. You can memorize the whole thing later on. I call your name, you answer. Okay. Memorize what is Faraday's law. Then tell me under Faraday's law, what are the steps to increase the current. Okay, please, 1 minute from now. Okay, time's up. 1 minute, sorry, Tia. Okay, now I will cover this thing now. Okay, come. Let me call your name, Mark. Jayin, Tan Jayin, are you there now? Tan Jayin, JY.
Yes,
ma'am. Tan Jayin, you answer now. Okay, can you tell me what is Faraday's law? What is Faraday's law, Jayin? Louder, speak louder, huh? Jayin, what Faraday's law? Again, come again, Jayin.
Magnitude of the induced current or induced EMF is directly proportional to
the magnitude of induced current is directly proportional to
rate of change of magnetic.
Directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux. Okay, okay, that's good. Okay, next, Ang Xiaohui. Are you there, Ang Xiaohui? Ang Xiaohui?
Yeah.
Ang Xiaohui, yes, can you give me one example? Under Faraday's law, right? How to increase the current?
Increase the number of turns of solenoid.
Yes, increase the number of turns of coil in the solenoid. When you have more turns, right? More turns, so you can cut more magnetic flux, right? Okay, that's good. Okay. No I. Are you there? No I. No I.
Yes.
Can you give me one more method how to increase the magnitude of induced current under Faraday's law?
Increase the speed of relative motion.
Yes, correct. Very good. Increase the speed of relative motion. You move faster, correct? Not? You move faster to cut the magnet so you can produce bigger current. Kaiji, Chiu Kaiji, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Chiu Kaiji, can you tell me one more method to increase the current?
Speed of relative motion.
Hey, this one, people answer already.
Strength of magnet.
Correct. Increase the strength of the magnet. Okay, use a more powerful magnet. So I think Faraday's law is okay. Okay, we are going to another one. This is headache one, I tell you. Headache, why I say headache? Because a lot of people cannot understand man. You better listen carefully, you know, but you cannot understand one. No? Later on you cannot understand one, you know. Okay, the second law is Lenz law. Lenz, L-E-N-Z. Lenz law. Okay. Lenz law, you see what Lenz law say. Okay, you highlight first. He said the directions of induced current always flows in such as a direction to oppose the chain which is causing it. You highlight the whole thing. Highlight, but I think you all cannot understand what he said. Never mind, read one more time. He said, direction of the induced current means the direction of the current generated, how the current flow, you know. He said, the direction of induced current always flow in such a way that to oppose means to goes against, oppose a chain which is causing it. Okay, now mind, you don't understand, you memorize it first. Memorize the Lenz law. Okay, now I explain to you. Okay, under this law, you say like this, you know, Lenz law say like this. You look at this solenoid. Can you look at here, everyone? Look at this diagram, this solenoid. Why I put the arrow like that, so that the current flow this way, right? Okay, when you see the arrow, this arrow point to the right side means the magnet pull out. Okay, now I use the magnet push in one to explain to you first. Can you look at this diagram? Okay, I think it's on this side. Slowly, now it will take some time. This part I know I will take longer time to explain to you. Here, look at this diagram. Later, I go back to the diagram just now. you look at this diagram first, okay? This diagram shows that when you push the magnet in, follow this arrow. When I want to push the magnet in, okay, I tell you what. The current generated here will flow in such a way that here become south. South, you know why south? Because to oppose it, ma. When this south pole want to come in, here will become south. When become south, to oppose it, oppose, because he said, always flows in such a way to oppose the chains of causing it, correct, ma? The chains of causing it means here is you push the magnet in. You want to push the magnet in, right? It will become south to stop, not to say stop, like it cannot stop also, like it to oppose, just trying to stop the magnet from coming in, okay? So it becomes south, south, and south will rebel, isn't it? Right? Trying to oppose, understand? Okay, now I explain to you, the south pole want to push in, right? So here becomes south. When here becomes south, here must be north, isn't it? You remember your this right hand grip rule or not? Right hand grip rule, right? Your right hand grip rule, your right hand hold like this one. You remember or not? Hold this coin. Now you see your other fingers must follow this direction, go up, go up, go up, go up, north. So meaning that your thumb point to north. So here is north, no? You want here to become south. Here is south, right? So here must be north. The thumb point to the north, so the current flow this way. So here, that's why I put the arrow here, I show the current flow like that. So mean the current flow this way, then come out. So now the pointer deflect to the right side, follow this direction, the current flow this direction. When the magnet push in, current flow this direction, okay? So deflect to the right. This is Lenz's law, you know. Okay, I tell you, Lenz's law say, the current, the induced current flow in such a way to oppose the chains in causing it. So the chains in causing it here is you push the magnet in, right? You push the magnet in, it's south, here is south, right? So here immediately it becomes south. When here is south means here is north, so the current must flow like that, based on right hand grip rule. So your other finger the current must flow, follow your fingers like that. So your thumb point to the north here, so here is south. So mean the current flow this way, right? When you push the magnet in, the current flow this direction, okay? So the pointer follow, pointer point to the right, okay? So this one is when you push the magnet in. So it become like that. When you push magnet in, current flow this direction, okay? Based on our right-hand grip rule, Lenz's law say, here must become south, okay? Wait, understand or not? Okay, now next, what about when the magnet pull out? Okay, pull out, we go back to the diagram just now I show you. This diagram. When you want to pull the magnet out, now you see here. Now, when you want to pull this magnet out, so here, south. The magnet just now here was south, isn't it? Now you want to pull it out. You want to pull it out, so here become north. Why become north? The current flow in such a way that here become north, you know why? Because when you want to pull the magnet out, it will become north to attract it, always oppose it. You want to go out, you don't allow it to go out. So you want to go out, you pull it back. So it become north, understand? So it become north here now. This is just trying to pull the magnet in up. Of course, it cannot stop the magnet from going out, right? Cannot. But it's trying to pull the magnet in, oppose it. Okay? To oppose the magnet from going out, right here must become north. So the current immediately change direction to flow that, so that here become north, here become south, right? Become north and south. You see your hand, your right hand grip rule, right? So thumb point here already. Here is north, now must point here, lor. So the current chain direction go down already. So it flow down, right? So it flow this direction, okay? So the pointer now deflect to the left side. Just now was right, now left. Understand? So now you understand what the Lenz's law or not? Lenz's law say, the induced current, this current always flow in such a way to oppose
the chains in causing it. You see, oppose the chain is in causing it. The chain in causing it means you move the magnet in, out. You always oppose it lah. When you want to come in, you oppose. When you want to go out, you pull it back like that. Okay? So Lenz's law. Then or not? Can I understand or not? Yvonne, do you understand Lenz's law now? Yvonne?
Still okay.
Can I understand or not? You listen to me for nearly 10 minutes already. Avril, do you understand Lenz's law?
Okay.
Okay lah, oh. Valerie, okay or not? Valerie, ah.
Yeah.
Mean what, oh?
Understand.
Can understand, ah. Kevin Chia, do you understand Lenz's law?
Yes, sir.
Can ah, Tang Mingyi, do you understand?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, okay, where is this Aisha? Aisha, where are you? Aisha, are you here? Aisha? Harnish. Harnish, do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Do you understand Lenz's law?
Yes.
Can I? Li Ka Chuan, understand? Harry Yong, Harry Yong, do you understand Lenz's law? Nah, Harry.
Still okay.
I know a bit hard. Never mind. Later on, you have time. You see the video again to go and understand it. Understand? Okay,
Okay.
I told you already one. For this part, you have to see a few times one. See the video again and again until you understand. Okay? I'm sure you see one time cannot. Second time you see, you can understand a little bit more. Lenz's law. Okay? Lenz's law is very important. Okay, next. Maybe I need to give you a little bit time to digest. I give you 2 minutes. You can read Lenz's law, read the 2 diagrams. Okay, I show the whole diagram for you. Okay, make this one bigger so that you can see everything now, okay? But one is on top, one is at the bottom, cannot, no way. Sorry, Never mind, you see this one first, okay? See this one when the magnet pull out. See here first, okay? Come. See first, okay, read here, read, memorize the statement, and then understand the diagram. Then after this, I show you another diagram, okay? Important is you must always remember, you know, when you want to pull the magnet out, right here, south. If this is south here, the current must flow in such a way that here become north to attract it back, to oppose it. You want to go out, oppose it means to pull it back, so become north. Lah. So current flow in such a way that here become north. When become north, you check with your hand, north. So mean the current must flow down like that, okay? And then you know the direction of current already, right? Okay, next diagram. This one. This one is when the magnet want to come in. Then you want to put the magnet in. Then push the magnet in. Here is south, here becomes south. Okay, you see or not?
always a pole sigma when the magnetic south pole want to come in, so here become south. Okay, you must remember, you know, if this is north, here also must become north, you know. North and north repel, correct not? So now it's south, so here is south. South means your hand should be like that, okay? Right? North here, south here, lo. So current go up, so flow like that. So direction of current like that, lo. Understand? Yeah. So land slow, Okay, now question time. Okay, Tan Wei Xiang. Tan Wei Xiang, are you there? Wei Xiang? Wei Xiang, are you there or not? Nú sao, Wei Xiang? Wei Xiang, are you there or not? No, not there. Ku Kian Ming. Kian Ming, are you there? Kian Ming,
Yes. Yes.
Kian Ming, can you tell me what is Lenz law? Lenz law is what? Can you tell me? Lenz law is blah, 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 blah. Lenz law is what?
Direction of an induced current always flows in such a direction.
Always flow in such a direction. How? To
oppose the change which is causing it.
Yes. The last part you must say, you know. You remember the statement, you know, you say Lenz law state that the direction of induced current flow in such a way that to oppose the change in causing it, the change which is causing it. Okay, that one is Lenz law. Okay, now 2 minutes time, can you go and fill up all the blank, okay, the below paragraph. Okay, here, the paragraph here, okay. I cannot let you see, okay, you can fill up. Use a pencil to fill up first. If you understand Lenz law, you should be able to fill up, okay? Please, 2 minutes, and fill up. Use a pen or pencil to fill up the blank. Do it now. The whole paragraph, Okay, time's up. Now, first answer is what? Yvonne, what is first answer?
Repulsive.
Yes, correct. Repulsive. Okay? Repulsive. Okay? When magnet move towards into the solenoid, move in, right? In the there is a force of repulsive, because sound will rebel, right? So we call it force of repulsive exists between the solenoid and magnet. And the NP is become what? Liao? NP become what pole?
Liao?
Yes, sound, correct. Sound pole. Sound pole, sound pole. And the next answer is direction of current in what direction? Direction of current in what direction? Tan Wei Yi? Tan Wei Yi, the direction of current in what direction?
Anti-clockwise.
Yes, correct. This one is anti-clockwise or like that, right? Anti-clockwise. Okay. So next. When the magnet is moved away, away means the previous diagram, just now I show you the one, move away from the solenoid, there is a force of what? Force of what? Jiu Kai Chi. Force of what? Jiu Kai Chi? Wen Gang. Yes, again.
Attraction.
Attraction, yes, correct. Attract impact muscle. Force or attraction, okay? And okay, now my lah, check the answer lah. Very hard to hide the answer, okay? Force or attraction exists between the solenoid and the magnet. The NP now become north. And the direction of current is just now anti-clockwise. Now the balik wind become clockwise direction now. Okay, clockwise direction. And the work done is converted into electrical energy. Work done means you move the magnet in, out. That is considered work done, you know. The work done now change to electrical energy lah. Okay. Yeah. So far can or Ang Xiao Hui, okay or not? Can I understand? Ang Xiao Hui. Yes, sir. Can I understand? Poon, P-O-O-N. Poon, can I understand? Poon. Poon no sao an. Tan Yun Si, do you understand? Tan Yun Si.
Yes.
Okay, for yes, swimming, sir. Okay. Assuming okay or not?
Yes, teacher.
Hui Xin, okay or not? Yao Hui Xin.
Okay.
Okay, what okay na? Yao Hui Xin na. Can you tell me what okay? Na Hui Xin na.
Understand.
Understand na. Okay. I don't want to catch out you already na. The next Okay, next is Fleming's right hand rule. Okay, please you understand this diagram first. Fleming's right hand rule. Now it's right hand. Right hand, you know. Okay, right hand same lah. The other day you learn Fleming's left hand. Okay, now I want to test you. Fleming's left hand, the other day you learn in lesson 2. The left hand is for what? Okay, remember, you know, you don't remember, you jot it down. Fleming's left hand rule is to determine the directions of magnetic force. You want to know the force, push to the left, push to the right, push up or push down. So you Fleming's left hand rule. Make notes, Fleming's left hand rule is to determine the direction of the magnetic force. So our result, look at the thumb. The thumb point up means force go up. The thumb point down means the force go down. That is Fleming's left hand. Now it's right hand, you know. Okay, Fleming's right hand, I see the function is determine the direction of current. Okay, so very obvious already. So to determine the direction of induced current, the current flow in what direction, right? When you generate the current, the current flow what direction? So use Fleming's right hand rule. Okay, right hand same way. Your thumb and your first finger must be 90 degrees. Here 90 degrees. Lock your finger, you know. Then your first finger and your second finger also here 90 degrees. Must be 90 degrees one. Okay, this is the same lah. Thumb, this thumb point to direction of the force. First finger direction of the magnet north to south. This is magnet north to south. Whereas the second finger follow the direction of current. Okay, so meaning that your Fleming's right hand rule, you always focus at your second finger. You want to know this current flow way. You always look at your second finger, see the current go where. Look at this here, this one, this finger one. Your Fleming's left hand, you look at your thumb one, always look at your thumb point where, the force go where. But Fleming's right hand, you always focus to your second finger, see where the current flow. Understand? The direction of induced current. Okay, please write it down. This function is to determine the direction of induced current. To find the current, go where? Go which direction? Okay? Fleming's right hand rule. Then after I tell you what, you learn left hand, you learn right hand, go far, then you don't mix up, you know. You mix up already. In the exam, they would never tell you one. This question, you left hand or you right hand. You have to know yourself. When you want to find the direction of current, use right hand. When you want to find the direction of the force, the magnetic force, use left hand, okay? And now, this one I think no need to explain, you already know, remember, thumb is a force, first finger is a magnetic field, direction north to south, second finger is a direction of induced current, okay? Now we look at an example. Look at this example, okay, now. AC current. Wait, the body one or no? Oh, it's still something here. Sorry. Yeah, look at here. Diagram not so clear, no? Correct not? Yeah. Okay. Look at this. This one is a generator, you know, okay? Why is it generator? Because we make this one turn to generate current one, you know. This is a wire. The wire is here. Huh? Cannot see the wire, right? Okay, here also got wire. Okay. Sorry. Yeah. So a generator or dynamo means you turn the coil. Use your hand to turn the coin to generate current. Okay, what you see is like this and all. Here got permanent magnetic field, you see that? North to south, this side your first finger follow north, south, you see or not? Follow magnet north to south, then you follow here. On this side, because I turn this coin to this direction, right? Anti-clockwise means that here the force is up. Here must be up. Here must be down, then only turn this direction, isn't it? Right? So I am taking on the right hand side now. So the force is up, this is your thumb point up. Okay? So when your thumb point up, your first finger follow magnet point here, north south, then you know that your finger come out. This finger come out, show the direction of current flow out. That's why I put the arrow out, you see? The current come out. See or not? Once you know the current flow out, that's enough already for you to find the current for other. Okay, I repeat again for this question, how to use a Fleming right hand rule. Okay, this is a two permanent magnet to produce magnetic field north to south. Here is a coil of wire. A coil of wire is like a turbine in the generator. Use a water power to make this thing spin. When this one is turning, it can produce current one, you know. So it can generate current now. Okay. Why the current is like that? How to determine the direction of current? Okay, let's say this coil turning in this direction, anti-clockwise direction. So now your hand, first you follow the magnet north to south. So this finger point north to south. Okay, your right hand, and then force this side, this wire, the force must go up because it's turning this direction. So the force is up. That's why your point, your thumb pointing up. Right? Then finally you look at your second finger is pointing outside. Point out, it shows that the current generated flow out. That's why this side the wire come out. So the current come out. So when wire, the current come out. You follow here, here go to this commutator, then it come out, cross over, then go back. You see or not? Here go back. Here you don't need to determine already. You know one. you hear the current come out, here current must go in one. Understand? Huh? Understand? So in the external circuit, the pointer deflect to the left side because current flow this direction. This direction, so the pointer will follow. Understand? Now you know how to use your flaming right hand already or not? Roughly lah, huh? Okay. Fill in the blank now. Yeah. When coin WXYZ, WXYZ here lah, rotates in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, don't ask me why anti-clockwise direction because it's given in the question. The question say the coin turn this direction. Okay, of course, this coin can turn any direction up to us. Okay, you want to make this coin turn like this, can. You want to make it turn the ballet also can, up to us one. Okay, but we are taking example this one turn anti-clockwise direction. The direction of induced current is in clockwise direction, not clockwise. Flow from here to here. You want to find the direction of current, you look at the external circuit one, you know, the product. So it's this direction is clockwise direction, it turn like that, clockwise direction, okay? Understand? Can understand Fleming's left hand rule, how to use Tan Wei Yi? Can you understand Fleming's left hand rule, Tan Wei Yi? Tan Wei Yi?
Yes.
Can understand how to use your left hand already, your right hand, sorry. Then, okay, the rest I think I don't want to continue now. I want you to answer some question. Can or not? Can you look at the tutorial one question? Can or not? Tutorial one. Do you have the, how many of you have the paper? Okay, tutorial one question. Yeah. Get a tutorial one question, Okay, come. Question one, what is answer? An electromotive force, which is a voltage lah, induced in conductor when conductor do what? Which condition can induce current? Okay. Chok, are you there, Chok? Chok, no sound. No sound, No sound means disappear already, Xing Fei, are you there? Very hard to call you all. You all no sound, no response one. Possuming. Come on, please. Question one, what answer possuming? Boy na.
I think it's boy.
EMF is induced in the conductor when the conductor to cut the magnetic flux, it must be moved perpendicular to the magnetic field lines. Okay, never mind. I think we have to continue our lesson. Cannot answer this question yet. Because you need to learn more first, then we can answer. Okay, never mind. Forget about this. We go back to the previous lesson just now. Okay, we carry on our lesson. You cannot answer yet. Okay, go back here. Okay, come look at this experiment. Okay. Now, my we learn finish, then only we answer question. Okay. Okay, now experiment. This experiment came out in the SPM, no? Experiment to investigate the relationship between the magnitude of induced current and the speed of relative motion. You already know the answer. The higher the speed of relative motion, when you move the magnet faster, right? The bigger the magnitude of induced current, we know the answer one, correct not? Okay, now hypothesis. Magnitude of induced current increases as the speed of relative motion between conductor and magnet increases. Okay, hypothesis highlight. Aim. Okay, the aim is to investigate the relationship between the magnitude of induced current and the speed of relative motion. Right? Okay, now variable. These two, can you exchange? Actually, the ballet already. Manipulated variable is this one, the height, H. This one is manipulated variable, is a height, H. Later, I tell you what is that. The height, H. Then, responding variable is the magnitude of induced current. Okay, this answer is magnitude of induced current is responding variable. The height H is a manipulated variable. Now please change. And the fixed variable is the number of turns of solenoid must be fixed. And the strength of the magnet must also remain constant. List of apparatus, you have zero center galvanometer, a galvanometer measure current. Solenoid, bar magnet and a ruler, right? Okay, here change up, please. Okay, now look at the diagram. I use a diagram to explain to you. When you look at the diagram later on, you understand already what is that, okay? Okay, like this. Our experiment, right, is to see the relationship between the current. I'm sure you know this experiment. When you allow the magnet to drop, the magnet drop down, right? So the magnetic field around the bar magnet, right, will cut by this wire, right? Cut by the solenoid. Then you can see the current come out here, correct not? So very simple experiment, just drop the magnet. Drop the magnet so that this magnetic flux cut by this conductor to generate current, right? But aim of this experiment is to see the relationship between the speed of relative motion and the magnitude of current. So common sense also know, right? When the magnet drops slowly, the current here smaller. When the magnet drops faster, so the current becomes bigger. The faster the magnet drop means the higher the speed of relative motion, isn't it? The higher the speed of relative motion, the bigger the magnitude of current. When the magnet drops slowly, the slower the speed of relative motion, the smaller the current. Okay, now the problem is how to make the magnet drop slower, drop faster? How to do that? How to do it? How to make the magnet drop slowly, drop faster? How to do it? No I? How to make the magnet drop faster and drop slower? No I? What you control?
The mass.
Control what?
Mass.
How to make this magnet drop faster or drop
use
slower?
Bigger magnet.
Bigger magnet. Do you remember just now the what is the manipulated variable? You remember or not? What you manipulate?
The height.
The height, correct not? The height, you see now. When height is here, when you drop it here, it drop very slow, correct not? When you increase the height, okay, you drop the magnet from higher place, right? Higher. When you drop the magnet here, higher, right? Higher here you drop, okay? Higher you drop, sure the magnet go faster, right? Like that. So meaning that You want to control the speed of the magnet drop, right? You manipulate the height. Okay, the height. When one is low, it drop very slow. When you make it higher, it drop faster. Correct? Not. Now you understand already. No, I understand or not? We control the height.
Sure.
Control the height. You want understand?
Yes.
We control the height. Okay. That's why the reason is manipulated variables. Just now I told you, right? Sorry that I do bring you move left and right. Okay. You see here, manipulated variable. Please change that. Manipulated variable is the height, h. Okay. The responding variable is the magnitude of induced current, the galvanometer reading. Now. And the fixed variable must be the number of turns solenoid must be same, cannot change the number of turns of solenoid. And the strength of the magnet also must constant. The magnet cannot change because the strength must always remain the same. Okay, now you understand already. Okay, now the experiment we do like that. Do a few. Okay, first, make it smaller so that you can see the entire diagram. Okay, here. First, you start the height or height with 5 cm. Okay, you put here 5 cm. Only 5 cm. So you drop the magnet. The moment you drop the magnet, you can see the pointer deflected to produce current. And then you record the reading is 1 milliampere. This milliampere, 1 milliampere. Next, you repeat the experiment. You make the height become 10 cm higher already, 10 cm higher. Then you drop. So now you go faster, isn't it? The magnet drop faster. Then you can notice that the current become bigger. Okay. So you repeat the experiment. First, you start with 5 cm, then repeat with 10 cm, 15 cm, 20, 25, and 30 cm. You can see, You can see when the height of the magnet where you drop increases, right? The magnitude of induced current also become bigger, correct not? So it's proven the experiment already now. Proven the theory is correct, isn't it? The higher you drop the magnet, the bigger the magnitude of current, bigger the magnitude of induced current produced. Understand, Okay. But in this case, our actual, we say the speed, right? But we never do the speed. We use the height to control the speed. Okay. Sometimes you do other things to change the speed one, you know. In this case, we manipulate the height of the magnet where the magnet drop to change the speed. Okay. Of course, common sense, you know, the higher you drop the magnet, the speed will become higher, correct not? Yeah. And last is the graph. The graph is like that. Okay. Directly proportional. This is a manipulated variable, the height. This is the magnitude of induced current, okay? Directly proportional graph. Okay, So far, can I understand? You guys can understand me or not? Huixin, can you understand me? Do you understand, Huixin?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Can Ming understand?
Yes.
Okay. Rian, you? Rian, do you understand? Rian?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, good. And your thumb, understand?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Brandon, understand?
Yes.
Yes. Selena, Selena, do you understand?
Yes.
Jocelyn, do you understand, Jocelyn?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, nah. Okay, thank you. Okay, Hanis. Hanis, what about you, Hanis?
Yes.
Yeah, can understand all. Harry Young, understand? Nah, Harry Young.
Yes.
Yeah, nah. Apple, do you understand Apple?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now. Tan Wei Yi, do you understand?
Yes.
Okay, okay, good. Okay. You have any question to ask or not? You can ask now or you can type in the chat. Okay, I see someone ask question. I want to read the question. This is Ngo. What is the different flaming right arm rule and the flaming left arm rule? Okay, Ngo. Can you listen carefully now? Your flaming's left hand is to determine the directions of magnetic force. Determine the force. The force push to which direction? Direction of the magnetic force. Push to the left, push to the right, or push up or down. That one is flaming's left hand rule. Okay? And now, Fleming's right hand rule, you have just learned, right? Right hand is used to determine the directions of induced current. The current induced, the current generated flow in what direction? So use Fleming's right hand rule. Ngo, can you understand or not?
Yes, understand.
You jot down, remember, left hand to find direction of force. Right hand to find directions of induced current. Everybody remember it, Okay. And your Fleming's left hand rule is in your lesson 2. Lesson 2, you can read that lesson 2, you see, determine the direction of the force one. Okay, the force. Then lesson 3 is the direction of the induced current. Use Fleming right hand. Okay. Any more question here or not? Let me check. I see some of you quiet and ask question here. Tan Yun Zi, can you explain once again the mechanisms of production of induced current in figure C? Okay, figure C, I go back to the question later. Kelvin, you asked, what is the difference between magnetic flux and magnetic field? Kelvin, they are the same, no different. Okay, magnetic field, magnetic flux, actually same, they are the same, Kelvin, understand?
Yes, sir.
Harry Young, Harry Young, kacau mi. Harry Young, you don't kacau mi lah. Okay, now Tan Yun Si, answer your question. In current in figure C, go back to C. C, I think is here, correct not? Is it this one? Tan Yun Si, see this one, correct not? See,
Yes.
Okay, come look at this one. Okay, now I explain this one. The mechanism of this generating current is like this, you know. The reason is why, you see, first you must see, you know, this diagram has no magnet, no permanent magnet. No permanent magnet means you must allow the current. That's why you use a battery. So the current flow inside here. When a current flow inside the solenoid, right? The solenoid becomes electromagnetic, so it becomes magnetic law. Means the magnet is produced by the current. So once this thing becomes magnetic, right? So it will behave like magnetic law. You have the magnetic field, magnetic flux, right? The magnetic flux. Okay, you see now, first time you on the current, this thing become magnetic. So this magnetic flux will come out, isn't it? So this magnetic flux come out will cut over here, cut over to the secondary, cut over to this coil of wire. So we say this magnetic flux link over to solenoid Q. The meaning that at here, magnetic flux cut by the wire happen here. So generate current. So you have current here already, right? But this only happen one time, Sunny. No, the magnetic flux cut here one time, Sunny, because this is direct current. Direct current means current flow in the same direction. So the magnetic flux also same direction one time only. It cut here, right? One time only. So just current generate a little bit of one time only. Then after that, you off the circuit. When you off it, what happened? Once you off, no current. No current already. So this magnetic flux will collapse. When no current means no magnetic flux already, no magnetic field. So this magnetic flux will then collapse. Collapse means it come back. When it come back means it cut. When it move back means it cut one more time. So cut here, it come back. So it cut. Okay. So to repeat to make the current continuously generated here, you must on, off, on, off the switch. Okay, I tell you what. When you on the switch, the magnetic flux cut over here. Cut over here. Cut. So you have current generator. Then you off the switch. When you off the switch, no more electromagnetic, No current, no electromagnetic. So this electromagnetic will collapse. Collapse means it will go back. When it go back, cut second time. You go back also cut one, Cut. So generate current. So by on, off continuously, okay? When you on, the magnetic flux cut over. When you off, you go back. On again, you come. Off, you go back. So on, off, so we cut, non-stop cutting here. So can produce a current continuously here. Understand? Then Yun Si can understand a little bit better now?
Yes, thank you, sir.
Okay. Any more question? Anyone you want to ask any more question? I see someone you type something. I cannot see the question. Come, I will check again. And now cannot see your name will come out. Okay. All right. What is the difference between move parallel and move perpendicular to the magnetic field lines? Move parallel and move perpendicular. Okay, like this lah. I need to use a piece of paper to explain. Okay, let me take out the whiteboard. I got whiteboard here or not? Yeah. Look at here. What is the meaning of moving parallel, moving perpendicularly? Okay. I take this example. Let's say this is magnetic field. Magnetic field like that, north to south. North to south, right? So this is permanent magnetic field, north to south. Okay. So over here you have a piece of magnet. So here is north. Right? Over here you have another piece of magnet. So it's south pole. Okay, so it's south. That means you have magnetic flux here, isn't it? Correct not? North to south called magnetic flux. Okay, now you see that. You want to generate current, you must use a wire, right? A wire. This wire connect to ammeter, okay? This is ammeter, right? You want to see the current generate or not. Okay, now how you move this wire so that it can produce current? You must move up and down, correct? Not move up and down means you cut the magnetic flux perpendicularly. You move up and down, okay? Up, or you move down, right? Okay, you move up and down means is perpendicularly to the magnetic flux. 90 degree, ma. Understand? The magnetic flux is horizontal. Your movement is move up and down means it's perpendicularly. Huh? Understand? Who asked a question just now? Okay, I want to ask you. In this case, you can generate current only when you move the wire up and down. Up and down to cut the magnetic flux. Up and down means 90 degree. Okay, because you move up means here is 90 degree. So here is also 90 degree, right? Okay, what about you move the wire parallel, can or not? Parallel to the magnetic flux. Can you cut? You move parallel, can cut or not? Yvonne, if you move this wire parallel, can you cut? Parallel means a move like this, a move left, right, can cut this magnetic flux or not?
Cannot.
Cannot. You must move up and down, correct not? Understand? Did I answer your question? Who asked the question just now? Okay, remember simple concept is yes, you move. Who asked it just now? I cannot see your name.
It's me. Me, Eric.
Understand now? You understand already?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Then something already, so I have to stop here tonight. Okay. So I want to stop here. Anymore, no more question already. Okay. So once again, I want to say thank you to everyone. Follow this lesson tonight. Many of you follow me for second time in this week. Okay. So take good care of yourself. Divide your time properly and continue to study. Don't stop studying. Okay, remember, never stop studying during this period. Okay. Someone still ask question. Happy holiday. This Harry Yong Kap Chao Wan. Happy holiday. Harry Yong, it's not holiday, you know.
I know. Just kidding.
Not holiday, So, wish everyone take good care of yourself, best of luck, study well at home, eat well at home, sleep well at home, and play well at home. Okay, I see you again next week. Next week, as usual, two lessons. Then the Hari Raya week, that week only one time, only Thursday, only Tuesday, no. Okay. All right. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Bye bye. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. Bye bye. Yeah. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Bye bye.